Hello and welcome to new SolidSteel parametric for SolidWorks video. Unlike most of our videos, today we are not focusing on the structure but on the facade. In the new version 4 of SolidSteel, the facade module has been completely redesigned and the features have been extended. This 24 by 12 meter hall with a flat sloped roof is our model, which is now provided with facades, facade cutouts, the roof and also edge sheets. We start with the, you guessed it, facade tool. On the right side you will find a selection of the facade elements. There's already a large selection of manufacturers and elements available here, but you can of course expand the library yourself. In the left column the element series is selected, in the right column the element size. The facade orientation is defined by selecting two lines perpendicular to each other. The origin of the facade is marked with a coordinate system. If the directions are displayed incorrectly, you can swap the direction with these checkboxes. Here everything is correct and we can select the other lines and the preview appears. Since the lines correspond to the dimensions of the structure, we now use the offsets to extend the facade as desired. All offsets refer to the selected origin. In order to save offcut in the facade elements, we can influence the placement of the elements with an entry at start position selection in such a way that we start with an element that is not cut. We define the cutout for the gate on the next page of the dialog. We add the lines for the facade cutout to the inner geometry selection by clicking on them. Confirm and our first facade is placed. The other walls follow. This works the same way, here now in fast forward. Okay, all the walls are up, but it's still raining in. Let's take care of the roof. To design the roof, we use the same tool, but of course we select the desired roof elements in the facade selection. By the way, you can mark often used elements as favorites down here. The favorites will then appear right here in the selection dialog. Placement of the elements and setting of the offsets is done exactly as for the walls, again in fast forward. Well, that already looks like a production hall. But I guess it's still very dark inside, so now we'll take care of the windows with facade cutouts. For this we use the tool Facade Cuts. On the sketch you can already see the planned windows. First we use the Facade Selection tool to select the elements that will be affected by the facade cuts. In the Cut Contour selection the lines for the cuts are selected. Confirm and the window openings are created. Now the second side according to the same principle. With this the shell is finished, now a few more details. We now add edge sheets with the tool of the same name at all element joints. Let's begin with this corner. First we select two faces. As you can see, it's not necessary to select exactly the elements directly at the corner. The actual edge is defined by the intersection of the two planes. Then we set the start and end points. In the settings, offsets and the overlap of the sheets can be defined. By selecting the checkbox Cut at End, the edge sheet will be cut flush at the end. We confirm the previous specifications with Preview Update and the current configuration is displayed with one sheet at the starting point. Further down we can define the dimensions of the sheets and also see the calculated angles. Here now 2 times 45 degrees for our right angled corner. We can confirm and SolidSteel lines up the required edge sheets. Now we repeat this for the remaining corners. Next comes the ridge and eave sheets. Again in fast forward because the steps are exactly the same as just shown. As you can see, the SolidSteel facade and roof module has become really extensive in the new version. This video is therefore rather to be seen as a schematic example and would have become much too long if all the details would have been shown. Therefore look forward to the upcoming videos in which all functions and constructive details will be shown in depth. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to show it with a like or a subscription. You can also find more information on our website. See you next time.